What's up, everyone? This is your boy Rod Clever. This is day 27 of the Post Every Night in September challenge. Today's video is all about National Gay HIV Awareness Day. Today is a very special day for gay people, and people may not be acknowledging it or aware of it, but anyhow, we're going to do this. So let's talk about HIV and bareback sex. If you don't know how HIV is transmitted, you should know now. HIV is transmitted through blood or semen or breast milk. It is not transferred from saliva or touching people or sweat. It is not transferred that way. You can get it from kissing. There are very small cases of contracting the HIV virus from oral sex. So if you choose to have oral sex, you should be responsible. If you are having sex, period, you should be responsible. If you are having sex, whether it's protected or unprotected, you should be getting tested every 6 months minimum. If you are having sex a lot and you're promiscuous, which is no judgment on that, you are an adult, you can do whatever you want. Just make sure that your decisions do not affect other people. You should be getting tested every 3 months. If you are on the receptive end of sex and you bottom, you should be getting an anal pap test annually. An anal pap test will check for HPV, and you can also get them to check for herpes as well. It's very essential because rectal cancer is very real. You don't want that. If you get that, they just can't remove that and just, you know, you can just live without it. Live without an anus and a rectum, you just can't. So you might want to get that taken care of. Because I'll be very, very candid. I get an anal pap test done every year, and I'm actually due for one in like a few weeks. So it's your health. You want to be here, you want to live and enjoy your life, I want to live and enjoy my life, I get tested, I take care of all my parts, make sure all my shit is working. I don't play that fucking game. But anyhow, for some reason, I feel like bareback culture has made a comeback and that it is something that is very cool to do. If you choose to have unprotected sex with anyone, I think you should be asking questions. Also, as well, if you're going to be having unprotected sex, you should be in a couple situation with somebody that you trust and you both have gotten tested together. You should just, if you want to have unprotected sex, you run the risk of an STI or HIV, and those are the things that no one wants to deal with. No one wants to have shit dripping from their dick or their asshole looking like a baboon's ass. And not making light or comedy of it, but it's very real and you should be very responsible. I get tested regularly. I have to take care of myself and make sure those things are taken care of. You get to a certain age in your life that you have to be responsible with your health and the things that you do with your body, because people won't respect your body or won't be honest with you or won't be sincere, or they will lie to you just to get you in the bed, and no one wants to be the victim of somebody else's bullshit. Also, nowadays, there is legislation to protect people from purposeful HIV infection, purposely getting infected by HIV by someone. But there are still some places that don't recognize it and they don't give hard time for it. And also in a court of law, you run into those oppositions of situations where can you prove that this person gave HIV to you? And I know that's kind of not where I plan on taking this video, but I'm going to anyway. It's one of those things where if you're going to have sex with people, you need to be very, very picky about the people that you sleep with. I know sometimes in gay culture there are sex parties, circuit parties, whatever kind of parties, gay prides, sizzles, Dominican Republics, infernos, wherever you go, and a lot of sex happens. And I think that the lifestyle is very geared and very wired for sex, because of course, and this is just from my point of view, that being that we historically have not had gay rights up until the last maybe few years or so, marriage and the idea of adopting very easily and procreation, we can't procreate. That's just not feasible as far as two men or two women being in the bed together. But those things weren't options. So I think I do understand why things are so sexually charged in that regard, because like, what are we really living for? We can't get married. We can't own property together. Not legally. We have a hard time adopting because of, you know, different things. And if you're a single parent, so many different things, like adoption is such a process. So I do understand why things are so sexual sometimes, but I'm praying that all these things in marriage rights and equality, these things are changed, will change our mindsets to be better gay people, and that we are not, you know, perpetuating the spreading of this virus. Also, as well, the reason why the virus spreads, in my opinion, is because people are afraid to talk about it. It is one of those things that is in culture that is going to be here for a very long time unless we discuss it. And yes, people with HIV are living very full lives. I don't know if we've gotten desensitized to the virus. I don't know what's going on. But it is very real. And to see someone that you are close with pass from it, or be even on the second hand of that, and I have been on the second hand of that, it is not a very good feeling. It is a very sad feeling. And when you talk about things that are so frightening, it wakes people up. And I think that even doing this video, if no one ever sees it, hope someone sees it, changes somebody's mind, make a right decision. If you're going to have sex, please use protection. Please be responsible and ask questions. And don't be ashamed about it. It is your body. You only get one. If it's gone, it's gone. You can't fix it. You can't get it back. And you don't want to do that. People in this world are living for you and expecting to see you show up. And I want you here. You need to be here. And not just here for my channel. You need to be here just for everything else. Life is so amazing. And to miss out on it because you have an opportunistic infection, or, you know, you are afraid of getting tested. And my thing is, if you are afraid of getting tested, and this is what I used to do when I was in my 20s. I said, hate getting tested. If I don't care if I suck somebody's dick or I had sex and everything was safe and everything was perfect and everything was clean, you know, whatever, I was still paranoid to get tested. Like, and my thing is that it never gets easier every time you get tested. But I do recommend the buddy system if you want to get tested with somebody that you trust. And regardless of your outcome of your testing, let's say if you do turn a positive, that you immediately get services and you immediately get help. People sometimes sit around so long with the virus and they start to deteriorate, and you don't want to be to the point where you're sick and you're beyond help. So just be responsible. Love yourselves. Don't be ashamed to love yourself. Don't be ashamed to love your body. I can't say this so many times, but just be so responsible. People are so dishonest sometimes, or they're not dishonest, they're so unaware and so negligent. And for you to lose your life or things around your livelihood change and you're susceptible to all these things, no one wants to deal with that. So, you know, find a buddy, go get tested. Today is a great day to get tested. Whatever you go get tested is anonymous. People don't know your information. You should give a fake name. Do what you got to do. Don't be ashamed of it. You know, it's 2013. People should be getting tested regularly anyway. HIV is here. I wish it would go away. It's just so many things, y'all. But anyhow, until next video, be safe, be sweet, take care of yourself, take care of your bodies, okay? If you like this video and you want to see more, make sure you comment, subscribe, like, and share. Come on, it's Ron Clever, and you're trying to get into this thing, so you should, like, subscribe, and it's awesome, and it's the best thing ever. And besides, sometimes I'm, like, totally not wearing clothes. So follow me. And also, you can find me on Twitter, at Ron Clever, also on Tumblr, at Ron Clever, on Instagram, at Ron Clever, and check out my blog, at ronclever.com. Love you all.